So the next thing that we have here is something called, you can call expanding brackets. And expanding brackets is something useful, meaning that, for example, but first I have to tell you a couple of things about a couple of rules. So let's say that now in the exact same way that you write, for example, a 1, a 2, a 3, a 4, a 5, and so on and so forth, or essentially a 59, a 65, and so on and so forth, or whatever number. The thing with the numbers is that, for example, a 4 can represent anything, any essentially abstract concept. Not any abstract concept, but essentially you can use it in any context. Meaning the 4 can represent 4 eggs, 4 apples, 4 hours, 4 kilometers, 4 meters, and so on and so forth, right? But then when you use essentially a number, there is one limitation, and the limitation is that a 4 can represent only a 4 anything, right? A 4 cannot mean a 5, but only a 4, right? Now, when, of course, we are going to get essentially as we go forward, we will essentially learn more about algebra. And algebra, then, instead of numbers, you can use variables. For example, an A, that is called a variable. A, B, for example, C, any letter that you find, or most letters that you find in the English language. So these are called variables. A variable can, well, the name, as the name suggests, it can vary, meaning it can change. Vary means to change. And variable means something that can be changed, which means that essentially if the situation needs me to do so, instead of a 4, I can use, for example, an A or a B or a C. And then the A essentially can now represent any of these numbers, right? Meaning an A in essentially, depending on the situation, it could mean a 4 or a 5 or a 6 or a 10 or a 100 or a 100,000 or whatever the number might be, right? So that's essentially a convenient way to generalize things, meaning to make things more general, right? Whereas if you use essentially a number, then you're making things more concrete, more essentially, meaning as you move towards, for example, these variables, you're abstracting things, making things more abstract. Whereas when you move towards the numbers, essentially, you're making things more concrete, more essentially tangible, something that you can touch, actually, right? And so now, what do I mean by all of this? Essentially, when I write essentially a 2 times, for example, 3 plus 5, I know that essentially this expression means, for example, since I have a bracket over here, I have to evaluate that first. That means that 2 times 3 plus 5 is equal to 8, and 2 times 8 is equal to 16, right? So this part has to be evaluated first, that you already know. But then on the other hand, 2 times 3 plus 5, also, I can essentially expand it in a different way. I can say that essentially there is 2 times 3 and there is 2 times 5, as in the example of, for example, Mina and Rita, for example. One of them buys 3 books, the other one buys 5 books. So together, meaning the bracket, together they buy 8 books. And then the price for each book is 2 rupees, then 2 times 8 is equal to 16, right? 16 rupees. Or essentially, one of them buys 3 books, so and the price for the book is 2 rupees, so 2 times 3 is equal to 6 rupees, and the other one buys 5 books, so that the unit price for the book is 2 rupees, so 5 times 2 is equal to 10, that's 10 rupees, 10 plus 6 is equal to 16 rupees total, right? Which means that essentially this calculation, I can write it as essentially 2 times 3 plus 2 times 5, right? So whenever you have essentially this type of situation, essentially you can expand it this way as well, meaning there is essentially addition over here, the addition comes over here, and then there is multiplication over here, and then the multiplication happens twice, for example, in this case. And of course, if you have, for example, 2 times 3 plus 5 plus 2, then you can write it as 2 times 3 plus 2 times 5 plus 2 times 2. You can write it this way, and any number of numbers that you have inside the parenthesis, you can do the same thing, right? Meaning that essentially this 2, which is multiplied by this whole bracket, distributes over the whole bracket. Distributing means 2 times 3 2 times 5 2 times 2. This is called distribution. And technically we say that multiplication distributes over addition. Okay, multiplication distributes over addition. And the same goes for subtraction as well, meaning multiplication also distributes over subtraction. For example, if I have suppose that Mina and Rita, one of them buys eight books, the other one or essentially there is only Mina. Let's say that there is only Mina. She buys 8 books. But then later on, she will return 2 of the books, -2, right? So now the total number of books that she has bought is 8 minus 2, which is 6 books, because initially she bought 8 books, but then for whatever reason, she decided to return 2 of them. Which means that now the actual number of books that she has bought is 8 minus 2, which is 6 books. And let's say that each book buys 6 rupees. So now essentially this becomes 6 times 8 minus 2, which is 6 times 6, which is equal to 36 rupees. That's the total amount of money that she had to pay for all of the books that she bought, right? And then the same thing, you can expand it this way as well. So this is 6 times 8. Minus 6 times 8 minus 6 times 2, which is the same thing as 48 minus 12, which is the same thing as 36, the exact same answer, which essentially suggests that multiplication also essentially distributes over subtraction, right? Now, why did I talk about these variables here? These are, of course, used extensively in algebra. But then, now, when it comes to, when we want to talk about, for example, when we say that, for example, multiplication distributes over addition, multiplication distributes over subtraction, then this situation is independent of the numbers that you use, meaning that essentially whatever the number that you use here, whatever the numbers that you use here, still the rule holds, meaning that whatever the numbers might be, in any case, essentially multiplication distributes over addition, or multiplication distributes over subtraction. And since this situation is a general situation independent of the numbers, then instead of the actual numbers, you can use variables representing any number, right? So then you can say that, for example, instead of a 6, I can write an A times, for example, instead of 8, I can write a B, and minus, instead of 2, I can write a C. And this is multiplication, for example, distributing over subtraction, which is the same thing as A times B minus A times C, right? So that's essentially how you use variables. So now, so far, essentially, we have learned about a couple of things here. But essentially, why I wanted to, essentially, in all of this, I wanted to point out to the fact that instead of these numbers, of course, whenever or wherever necessary or possible or appropriate, you can use variables in algebra. And moreover, the fact that multiplication distributes over addition and also over subtraction, which is something that you use in order to do many different types of things, expanding numbers, doing calculations, and so on and so forth. Okay. Now, let's take a look at a couple of examples here. Let's see how we can actually use this distribution law and see how we can use it. Okay, so now as an example, we can consider, for example, 7 times 109, right? Now, 7 times 109, technically, if I were to do this calculation, I'd have to write essentially 109 times 7, and then do the calculation this way. So 7 times 1 is equal to 63, and then 7 times 1 is equal to 7, that's 763, right? But then, now you can imagine that, of course, if it was something more complicated, or essentially you see that essentially doing the calculation actually needs you to do some fairly complicated calculation, right? Now you can make this easier. How can you make this easier? So you know that essentially 109 is nothing but 100 plus a 9, right? And I'm writing this as 100 plus a 9 because of the fact that, well, of course, I don't know what is, for example, 7 times 109, that I don't know from memory, right? But I already know that, for example, 7 times 100, anybody knows that it's essentially 700. So you don't even have to think about it, right? Which means that basically the 109, I can write it as 7 times 100 plus a 9. And write it, of course, this way in parentheses, meaning that the 7 is multiplied by the whole of 109, not just by the 100, right? And now we can use the rule that we learned about distribution of multiplication over addition, which is A times, for example, B plus C is the same thing as A times B plus A times C, meaning A times B plus A times C, right? And of course, this you can write it, meaning that you, as we mentioned before, you can, whenever possible, you can omit the multiplication sign, meaning instead of writing A times B plus C, you can write A times B plus C. And A times B, you can write it as AB. And A times C, you can write it as AC, right? Now, this type of thing, of course, using numbers, you cannot do, meaning that, for example, a 2 times 3, you cannot write it as 2, 3, that becomes a 23. So this is not possible. But when you use variables, you can basically, instead of A times B, you can write A, B, basically, okay? Now I can use this rule to do this calculation. So what I can do is that, so this is essentially the same thing as, this is the same thing as 7 times 100 plus 7 times a 9. So 7 times 100 plus 7 times a 9, right? And there is no problem in writing in my expression, because As you know, essentially multiplication has precedence over addition, which means that first this part has to be done. So 7 times 100 is 700. Plus 7 times 9 is the same as 63, right? So then this is the same thing as... So, and you know that 700 plus 63 is nothing but 763. So now the calculation becomes very simple using the same distribution rule. Or for example, let's say that you have some other calculation, like for example 102 times 103, right? So of course you have to think it out in advance and see essentially how you want to write your expression in such a way that the calculation becomes easier. Or essentially sometimes you want to prove something, so you want to write your expression in such a way that the proof becomes possible or simple, or and so on and so forth, right? So now 102 times 103, I have to write essentially 102 times 103. And of course, there is one way that you can actually do this calculation even without doing anything. You see, for example, 103 is the same thing as 100 plus a 3, right? And when you say essentially 102 times essentially 103, that means essentially in reality, in the based on the rules of calculation, that means essentially you have 102 and you multiply it by 100, and then you also have the 3 part, so you have 102 times basically a 3, and then if you add these two together, you would get to the result of this calculation instead of writing essentially some operation like this. Okay, so what is 102 times 100 is simple. You just write your 102 and add two zeros. That's a 10,200. 102 times the 3 is simple, because 3 times 100 is a 300, and 3 times 2 is the same thing as 6, so that's a 306. So that is 306. And now you can essentially add these together. Of course, this is something that you would probably do in your mind, probably, or even on a piece of paper. So that's a 6, that's a 0, that's a 6, that's a... So essentially, a 10,200 plus a 306, that's a 10,506, essentially, right? That's a 10,506. I can do the calculation this way as well, right? Now, but then you can use your calculation also a little bit more. I mean, this way you might actually make a mistake, meaning that the way that you have written your calculation, although there is nothing wrong with it, but it's not that systematic. You might actually make a mistake. You can do it this way. Okay, so now in order to write this as a to write essentially this as essentially in a more systematic way using the rules of distribution that we just learned, what you can do is that you can write and then essentially the same distribution rule that we learned, we can actually add something to that, and that is the fact that so far we said that, for example, a 2 times a 3 plus 5 is the same as, you can think of it as a 2 times, for example, 3 plus 5 is equal to 8, and that's the same thing as 16, right? Which you can write as 2 times 3 plus 2 times 5, right? So that's the same thing as essentially 6 plus 10, which is the same thing as 16, the exact same thing that we had over here, right? So that's the exact same thing. Now, so now this is essentially what we already know. But then we can expand this also to We can expand this also to a little bit, meaning that you see this 2 over here that I have right before the whole parenthesis and essentially right before the brackets, and it's multiplied by the whole of the brackets. In the exact same way, whatever I have here, it's going to be multiplied essentially again by the whole of bracket, meaning the whole of this 2 is multiplied by the whole of this thing, right? Meaning the 2, I can write it, meaning when you write twice 3 plus 5, that means essentially 1 times 3 plus 5 plus another 1 times 3 plus 5. If I say, for example, 3 times 3 plus 5, that means essentially a 2 times 3 plus 5 plus another time 3 plus 5. Or essentially it means basically this whole thing essentially means a 3 plus 5 plus another time 3 plus 5 plus another time 3 plus 5, right? In the exact same way that you say that the 3 times 5 is the same thing as, for example, a 5 plus a 5 plus a 5 3 times, right? In the exact same way, a 3 times 3 plus 5 is the same as 3 plus 5 plus 3 plus 5 plus 3 plus 5 3 times, right? So now that, and 3 times means, for example, 2 times plus 1 time, right? So that means that essentially this same thing, I can write it as instead of writing 3 times 3 plus 5, I can write it as 2 times plus 1 time, which is 3 times 3 plus 5. And now essentially the whole of this has to be multiplied by the whole of this, meaning that it is 2 times 3 plus 5, which is essentially 2 times 3 plus 2 times 5. So this part becomes 2 times 3 plus 2 times 5. And then add to that, because I have addition here, that's 1 times 3 plus 1 times 5. So that's 1 times 3 plus 1 times 5. Which is the same as essentially a 6 plus a 10 plus a 3 plus a 5, which is the same thing as 16 plus 8, which is the same thing as 24, right? And if you calculate this over here, that's the same thing as essentially 3 times 3 plus 5, which is 8. 8, 3 times 8 is equal to 24, the exact same thing that I got here, right? So if I generalize this, I can say that basically instead of these, all of these whole business of numbers, I can use variables. And it's the same essentially law of essentially distribution of multiplication the same essentially business of multiplication, distribution of multiplication over addition. But essentially a little bit expanded. So instead of these numbers, I can write essentially 2, 1, and so I can write A plus B instead of 2 and 1 times basically 3 plus 5. So C, for example, plus D, which is the same thing as A times C plus A times D. A times C plus A times D. And then you have also B times the same thing. So B times C and B times D. So add to that B times C plus B times D, right? So this I could write as AC plus AD plus BC plus BD. Right. So now this rule we can essentially use it over here. We can use it essentially in the case of this calculation. What I can do is that I can say that this is nothing but, for example, 102. I can write it as 100 plus a 2, right? Times 103, which is 100 plus a 3. And now I can essentially the same distribution law. So 100 times this whole thing plus a 2 times this whole thing. So 100 times this whole thing would be, for example, 100 times 100 plus 100 times a 3. So that's 100 times 100 plus 100 times a 3. And then I have the 2 times the exact same thing, which is 2 times 100 and 2 times a 3. So 2 times 100 plus 2 times a 3, right? So you know that 100 times 100 you can calculate easily, meaning that you have essentially a 100, for example, this 100, and then since it's being multiplied by 100, you have to add 2 zeros. That's a 10,000, right? And then 100 times 3 is nothing but the 300. 2 times 100 is nothing but the 200. And 2 times 3 is equal to 6. Now you know that essentially 200 plus 300 is 500 plus a 6 is a 506. So that's 10,000 plus a 506. And then 10,000 plus 506, that's 10,506. That's how you can essentially multiply this to do this calculation. Okay, now there is another interesting example here. So that is basically 17 times 109. So what you can do is that, for example, in this case, you can write as 17. You can write it as a 10 plus 7, right? This is just to show you the different types of things that you could do. Otherwise, I wouldn't personally do essentially solve this problem this way. But anyhow, it's just an interesting way of expanding things. So essentially, at 17 would be a 10 plus 7 times essentially 109. If I leave the 109 as it is, right? And this is the same thing as, so essentially this is 109 times a 10 plus 109 times a 7. So that's a 10 times 109 plus 7 times 109, right? 10 times 109 is easy. So you can actually write this part as already, because there is a, essentially you have 109 times 10, so you just put a zero over here. But just to make things essentially unnecessarily complicated to see the different things that you can do. So, for example, 109, you can write it as 100 plus a 9. So, you can write it as 10 times 100 plus a 9. And basically, plus 7 times 109. So, essentially, again, 109, you could, again, write it as 100 plus 9. So, that's 7 times, essentially, 100 plus a 9. And that's the same, and now you can basically expand, meaning 10 times this whole thing, that's a 10 times 100, 10 times a 9. 7 times this whole thing would be 7 times 100 and 7 times a 9, right? So you can write it as 10 times 100 plus 10 times a 9 plus 7 times 100 plus 7 times a 9. And so, of course, 10 times 100 is 1,000, 10 times a 9 is a 90, 7 times 100 is a 700, and 7 times a 9 is equal to 63, right? And so, essentially, 1,000, that's 700 plus 90 is a 790. So you have a 790 there, plus 1,000, that's 1,790. Right, so that's 1790 plus 63, which then you can write as so if this was an 1800 plus 63, that would be 1863, and then subtract 10 from here because it's a not it's 1800 but 1790. Subtract 10 from here, that gives you 1853. That is 1853. So that is again another way that you can make calculations simpler. If I were to write basically, if I were to add 1790 plus 63, that would essentially, now when it comes to me at least, it might confuse me. I might make mistakes. Or I have to write, for example, 1790 plus 63 this way and then do the calculation, right? But then I can, because essentially we know how numbers work, meaning we know the essence of numbers, we can put them together, we can rip them apart, again we can put them together, whatever you do based on the laws, essentially based on the structure of numbers that you know, that works in calculation. And there is also, and essentially most of the things, or essentially some of the things, there is something called Vedic mathematics. Vedic mathematics is the, I mean, are all of these very smart ways of dealing with numbers, doing mathematics, so on and so forth. So that's again kind of, I mean, I suspect that that's one way that Vedic mathematics could have been developed essentially. So for example, doing this calculation, 1719 plus 63, it's fairly complicated, at least in my head. So I could then say that, for example, a 1700, I can take it as an 1800. And 1800 plus 63, I already know that it's 1863. That's easy. But then here I'm supposed to give 10 back because this was not an 1800, but a 1790. So I take 10 back from this number. That would be 1853. That's essentially how you do this calculation. Okay. So that's essentially all of these different things that you can do with brackets. So I hope that this video was helpful. Thank you.